Hello and welcome to the Street Crime UK YouTube channel. Please don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Today we look at how police joked with convicted robber Richard Ricky Smith they were coming for his teeth when they caught up with him. Like the rest of his lifestyle, his pearly white teeth had been funded by theft and GMP detectives bantered about seizing them as proceeds of crime. But a judge has ruled Mr. Smith, the leader of Great Manchester's most prolific cash-in-transit robbers, must hand over £57,000 within 3 months or face another 16 months on his sentence. Mr. Smith and his wife Lisa enjoyed a champagne lifestyle. They spent £16,000 on their teeth, married at five-star Lowry Hotel, splashed out on private healthcare and luxury holidays. That was all put on ice when they were jailed alongside each other at Manchester Crown Court in 2011. Mr. Smith got 11 years for arson, escape and money laundering, while Lisa got 18 months for money laundering and fraud. Despite that, Mr. Smith had little intention of going straight. He and his gang committed 7 robberies between February and August 2017, netting £288,000. Mr. Smith and 3 other members of the gang were jailed. Mr. Smith, 38, of Pegwell Drive, Lower Broughton, Salford, was given a 10-year sentence after pleading guilty to conspiracy to rob, 2 counts of robbery, and 1 of attempted robbery. Patrick Madonna, 38, of Ridge Crescent, Whitefield, pleaded guilty to conspiracy to rob and 2 counts of robbery and was also jailed for 10.5 years. At the same proceeds of crime hearing, Mr. Madonna was ordered to pay back £71,700 within 3 months or face an extra 18 months in prison. Judge Susan Goddard QC also imposed serious crime prevention orders on both of them. Mr. Smith and Mr. Madonna both accepted receiving about £65,000 from the robberies, which netted £288,000 in total. Mr. Smith's gang development knew criminal methods in a bid to get rich quickly, forcing cash delivery men to change their logistics and led GMP's thief takers to mount surveillance and set a trap. Each raid was meticulously planned and executed with ruthless efficiency. A sledgehammer, crowbar and a battering ram were the weapons of choice, and top-of-the-range cars like a Volkswagen Golf R32 were the preferred means of escape. Dressed in head to foot in black, the gang would use up to 3 stolen getaway vehicles, burning some in their wake. Squeezy bottles of bleach and kitchen roll were carried in vehicles to wipe away traces of forensic evidence, along with sports bottles filled with petrol to torch them. The team of professional criminals were dubbed the Wham Ram Gang because of the technique used in 5 of the raids. Most gangs would target cash deliveries to shops, banks, post offices, building associates and ATMs, try and snatch the money from the guard's hands. Instead, this gang would grab hold of the guard, threaten him into opening the rear door of his van. Prosecutors learned they used a Wham Ram, a specially designed battering ram, to smash through the internal doors of G4S cash vans to get at the money. By doing things this way, they hoped to get all the cash on the driver's round at once and eliminate the risk of the security die being activated. The spree of Ram Ram robberies began on February 15th, 2017 at the Halifax Bank in Sale. The gang hit the jackpot at the first attempt, escaping with £195,000. The gang were being watched when they carried out their final raid on August 29th, 2017 at McColl's Post Office in Carbank Street, Atherton. Armed with a crowbar and a sledgehammer, they assaulted the manager and forced the guard to open cash boxes, but all they got was a load of stamps. They drove off in a Vauxhall Vectra before switching to a VW Caddy and then a Volkswagen Golf R32. Police intercepted the Golf on the car park of the pub near Junction 4 on the M61. Mr. Madonna was arrested and Mr. Smith, Mr. Groom and Mr. Dargan were chased towards a motorway slip road where they attempted to carjack an elderly couple. The 64-year-old driver was punched in the face. 3 members of the gang were all caught on CCTV attempting to flee but were caught by police. The other members of the gang, John Groom, 36, of Manchester Road, Worsley, and David Dargan, 33, of no fixed address, both admitted 2 counts of robbery and 1 count of attempted robbery and were sentenced to 6.5 years in prison. In 2001, Mr. Smith was jailed for 5 years for the manslaughter of former paratrooper Ben Karamanalagu. Ben was beaten to death in a gang attack because he had the temerity to throw Mr. Smith and his friends out of a Manchester nightclub while working as a bouncer. In 2010, having been freed from that sentence, Mr. Smith torched a vehicle recovery unit used by police in Walkden in what was understood to be a bid to destroy evidence linked to a crime. Just 24 hours after his arrest, on his way to magistrates, he was sprung by pals from a prison van carrying him before going on the run. Mr. Smith was arrested 6 months later on the Costa Blanca, where Spanish police suspected he was planning a robbery before being extradited to face justice. Detective Sergeant Riz Casley of GMP's Serious and Organized Crime Group said, "I am pleased that today, Mr. McDonough and Mr. Smith have been ordered to pay back a substantial amount of their ill-gotten gains. They stole a huge amount of money and in doing so risked the safety of businesses, employees and the members of the public. I'm sure they thought their criminal exploits would make them wealthy men, but instead they are behind bars and have been stripped of their assets, which I hope sends a clear message that crime does not pay." So what are your thoughts about Mr. Smith and how he went on to live the luxury lifestyle from funds that he gained through robberies and money laundering? And how, even after going to prison, Mr. Smith would fall back into the life of crime after being released almost immediately? Please share your thoughts in the comments below. Thanks for joining us, and until next time, stay safe.